The previous class we were discussing important examples of IUPAC nomenclature. So today we continue with the same, some important examples of IUPAC system of nomenclature of organic compounds. Okay, so now here morning what we discussed, this question we were discussing. Okay, this question we were discussing. In this case now, in first option, the old name used like this here. Suppose if any other than the same groups present here, three COOH groups there, three COOH groups there, and one OH group is there. In this case, what we have to understand, in all notation, what they were giving here, it is pent, P-E-N-T, morning I told you. So pent-N, so here first carbon 1, and it is 5, and it is third carbon. And on third carbon, hydroxy is there, carboxy is there. So what we said here, 3 carboxy and 3 hydroxy, pent-N, 1,5 dioic acid. On first carbon, 1 oic acid. On fifth carbon, 1 oic acid. Dioic acid, we have said. It is old name. Old naming. According to old system of naming of IUPAC nomenclature, it was given. It is old name. But then same thing we can say, modern, according to modern concept, we can say like this here. Now here, again, same groups three times repeated. Na? First carbon, second carbon, third carbon to be given here now. As I said in this case here, these three only should be taken as parent chain at all now. The first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. Otherwise, here one, here two, here three. So 1, 2, 3 only should be given. These carbons should not be given numbering. Because same groups repeated more than two times, I told you. That's what we said here. Propane, 1,2,3, 1,2,3, tri. Carboxylic acid we have given, right? The same way here, in this case also, here as COOH groups three times repeated, again the same three carbons only should be taken here in the parent chain. 1, 2, 3 should be taken. In this 1, 2, 3 here, on third carbon COOH, on second carbon COOH, on first carbon COOH there. And also on second carbon hydroxy group is there. So what we can say now, this name, 2-hydroxy, according to modern concept, this one, 2-hydroxy propane, then 1,2,3, tricarboxylic acid, we have to say. Like here on in the option B, whatever is given, same name, propane 1, 2, 3, tricarboxylic acid should be given, and 2-hydroxy we have to say. It is what now account modern concept. It is account old concept, but it was used. That's why we are taking this one also correct option only. First option also correct option we are taking. Okay, and the second option also correct option. Propane 1, 2, 3, tricarboxylic acid. And third option is wrong here, incorrect. Why third option is incorrect here? Here, same groups are there here. They should give numbering only to these three carbons. But here, only prop should be root word. But here, pent given. That's why it is wrong. Okay? Now, next, fourth one is very important. Fourth one is correct name here. It is very important concept, remember here. Now, very carefully, we have to observe this one here. Now, at one end, what is there? COOH group is called what? Carbon containing group. Okay, and then what is given here? CH2 given. CH, the same thing I'm drawing here. COOH bond, CH2 bond. It is what now? C double bond O, single bond H. That means CHO only now it is. Carbox means what here? Aldehyde group it is. CHO group is what? Here CHO group is aldehyde functional group here. It is carboxylic acid group, right? Now here, whenever we take COOH and CHO, these two groups, which is senior group, I told you, COOH group is more senior than aldehyde group. That's why it is principal functional group COOH, and CHO is what now here? Substituent. For this CHO, we have to use which name? We have to use formyl. Formyl should be used here. And for COOH, which name we have to use now here? Oic acid. What should be used here? Oic acid. So oic acid for COOH and formyl for CHO should be used here. Now while giving numbering, this concept is important. So first carbon, second carbon and third carbon. That means if the CHO group, that is carbon containing group, is along with oxygen, suppose. If carbon containing CHO group, if it is containing oxygen, that should be given, that carbon should be given numbering. Then we have to give number 3 to this carbon. Okay, suppose I am taking like this here, the same molecule I am taking here, COOH bond CH2 bond CN. It is what now, carbon containing group only. Cyanide is what? Carbon containing group, but without oxygen here. Without oxygen. The CN group is what now? Without oxygen atom. Carbon containing. Now again, between CN and COOH, what is principal? COOH is principal group and should be allotted first position. And it is second position. Now numbering should not be given here. For this carbon, CN, carbon, the three, position 3 should not be given, remember this one. In which case we should not give numbering to this carbon. If the carbon containing group like COOH is principal group, this carbon should be given, the carbon of principal functional group should be given first position. Numbering should be started from this carbon. Then we have to go up to this carbon only. The CN should not be given numbering because it doesn't contain oxygen. If the CHO, the terminal carbon containing functional group, has oxygen, in that case only we have to give numbering to this carbon. Here, for CHO, numbering should be given. But for CN, numbering should not be given. This point we have to understand. Okay. So here, numbering is not given. How many carbons in the parent chain now? Only 2 carbons. Only 2 carbons in the parent chain. It is what now? It's 2 carbons with single bond, ethan oic acid. In this ethan oic acid, on second carbon, what is there? 2 cyano is there. 2 cyano. 2 cyano ethan oic acid. 2 cyano ethan oic acid is named here, that's all. We did not give numbering to this carbon, right? But here we have given numbering to this. And now tell me here, for this CHO, what is the name to be used here? Formyl should be used here. We should not use AL for CHO. We should use only formyl. And then here, first carbon is having what now? COOH. It should be given first position, second position, third position. So what is the name now? 3, formyl. Here, first letter should be capital, remember. First letter must be always capital. 3, formyl, propanoic acid. 3 carbons in the parent chain, na? So propanoic acid. So 3, formyl, propanoic acid is correct answer. So it is also correct. Only this one is incorrect. Only the C, option C is incorrect. Is that clear my concept? Once take the screenshot of this very important concept, this one. Based on this only questions will be there. Now, based on this some questions I'll give you. Now you try to answer them. Now check it here. Just a moment. Now see, in this case, suppose what we are taking previous one. So now one more example I'll give based on this. You have to answer now. Okay. What is the name of that molecule we have to say? Now suppose I'm taking here CHO bond, CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CN is given. Suppose this molecule is given. What is the IUPAC name of this molecule we have to say? So based on this concept, I'm taking here. Now in this case here, CHO group is there, CHO functional group is there, CN functional group is there. Both are there here. In this case, numbering, which is priority group here? CN is priority group here. OK. Okay, so priority group, if you take, what is more priority here? Cyanide group is. Cyanide group is more priority than what? Formyl group here. That means what now? Than CHO. Than CHO, CN is priority group here. So in this case, what we take number one here to this carbon, we have to start 1, 2, 3, 4. Then this carbon should be given or not numbering? It should be given. Why? This carbon containing group, the carbon containing group is along with oxygen. If carbon containing group is along with oxygen, that carbon should be given position. Fifth position we have to give to this. Now here 5-formyl should be there here. 5-formyl. And here at first position, what is there? This group is called what? What is secondary suffix name for this? What is secondary suffix of this cyanide? It will be nitrile. What is this? Nitrile is IUPAC name. Means the secondary suffix name of cyanide. And what name, which name we have to use here for formyl? What is secondary prefix? Secondary prefix of this CHO is what? Formyl. Formyl. So formyl is secondary prefix, remember. Secondary prefix. But here, secondary suffix is what? Nitrile. Secondary suffix is nitrile. Okay, now tell me name, IUPAC name of this molecule. Now see, how many carbons total in the parent chain? 5. So 5 indicates what? Pent. Pent. And then, what is the secondary prefix? Prefix means it should be written before word root. Before root word we have to write. There it is, fifth position. So 5-formyl. 5-formyl pent. An or en between all carbon atoms. Single bond only there. Don't take this double, this triple bond here. This triple bond is between carbon and nitrogen here, not between the carbon atoms. So between the 5 carbon atoms, single bond is there. So AN. E also we have to write. E also we have to write. Why? The nitrile, first letter is what? Secondary suffix. Secondary suffix, first letter is what here? N. N is consonant. It's not vowel. So when the secondary suffix name starts with the consonant, we should write E, A-N-E. Okay, pentane nitrile. Pentane nitrile. Is that clear, ma? So it is what now here? 5-formyl pentane nitrile is IUPAC name of this molecule. Here, why? Which is senior group here? CN. Cyanide is senior than what? CH. Is that clear, ma? Now, one more example, check like this. One more example I'm taking. Here, COOH bond. CH2 bond, CN. Suppose it is given as this, cyanide. Now here, how many functional groups in this molecule? Cyanide group is there, functional group, and COOH, carboxylic acid group is there. So now in this case, numbering should be started from which one? Which is principal functional group here? Principal functional group is what? COOH. COOH. And second grade functional group is what? Cyanide. It is substituent now. Now what, which name should be used for COOH? For COOH, which name we have to use now? We have to use oic acid. For this we have to use oic acid. Oic acid. And for this cyanide group, what we have to take now here? Cyano. Cyano is what? Secondary prefix name. Secondary prefix name of cyanide group here. And this oic acid is what? Secondary suffix. Secondary suffix of principal functional group. And for second grade functional group, we must use the secondary prefix name. Cyano we have to use. But here in this example, we have used what? Nitrile. This nitrile is what? Secondary suffix in this case. This is one thing to understand first. After that, numbering should be understood here. Numbering should be started from which one? From COOH, we have to start numbering, right, ma'am? So number one is what now? COOH. Number two, this one. Number three here. Number four here. Right. Number four. After this, now to this fourth carbon, which group is attached here? CN group is attached. CN group meaning what? Cyanide group is attached. Cyanide. Which is attached here? Cyanide. And this carbon should be given position or not? Numbering should be allotted or not? Tell me. We should not give any position to this carbon because this is the chain terminating carbon containing functional group without oxygen. The chain
So listen carefully and try to understand each and every point what we are discussing now. Suppose one example I'm taking here. COOH bond CH2 bond CH2 bond CH2 bond CN. CN means what? Cyanide, na? C triple bond N. Cyanide is N. Suppose this type of compound is given. When this type of compound is given, membering should be started from which one? A COOH group is there, carboxylic acid group is there, cyanide group is there. Two groups are there. When two groups are there, one should be principal group, one should be second grade functional group, right? So a principal group is COOH and number one should be given to this carbon. And second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon. After this, C. Now, whenever COOH from this end, when we start numbering, the other end is the carbon-containing functional group. It is carbon-containing functional group. To this, numbering should not be allotted. To this cyanide carbon, numbering should not be given. Five we should not give. Five we should not give. Four carbons only we have. So parent chain should contain now how many carbon atoms? Only four carbon atoms. So five carbon atoms should not be given. So four carbons in the case of butte. And what is the name to this COOH to be used? Oic acid. Oic acid is secondary suffix or secondary prefix? It is secondary suffix. And for cyanide, what name we should use here? For cyanide, we have two names. Cyano and nitrile. Cyano and nitrile. Here we have to use what now? Cyano. Cyano should be used here. So cyano is what? Secondary prefix or secondary suffix? It is. Secondary prefix name for cyanide should be used. It is what now? Substituent. Second grade functional group here. For this cyano only should be used here. For COOH we have take oic acid. Oic acid. So it is what now we look like this. Now numbering started from this end and we should not end with this carbon. Only we should stop here only. Then four carbons are there. Now name tell me. On which carbon cyano group is attached? On fourth carbon cyano group is there. Remember. So we have to say now name. Four cyano. How many carbon atoms in the parent chain? Four carbon atoms. So butte. And between the carbon atoms, which bond is there? Single bond. Single bond indicates what? An and. Okay. Cyano. Butte. An. Oic acid. COOH. What is this name here? Oic acid. So butane. Oic acid. So oic acid is secondary suffix name. An is what? Primary suffix name. Butte is what? Word root. Cyano is what? Secondary prefix name. So like this we got what now here? 4-cyano-butanoic acid. Okay. So it is IUPAC name. Is that clear? So numbering should not be given to this type of chain terminating carbon containing functional group without oxygen. Remember. If oxygen is there, we have to give numbering to this carbon. If oxygen is not there in the chain terminating group, we should not give numbering to this carbon. In the cyanide, oxygen is not there. It is carbon containing functional group without oxygen. So numbering should not be given. This point we have to keep. Okay. Now, take the screenshot of this. So next example is that. See. Suppose I'm taking like this. CHO. All you have. CHO. CH2. CH2, CH2, COOH. Now in this molecule, how many functional groups are there? One, two. Two functional groups are there. Which is senior group here? COOH group is senior. When COOH group is senior, it should be allotted first position. Ma? So first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon and fifth carbon. We should give numbering here now. Because the CHO is what? Chain terminating carbon containing functional group. Chain terminating means at the end of chain it is there now. So it is called chain terminating functional group with oxygen. With oxygen. It should be allotted position here. So we have to give number 5 to this carbon. Okay. Now for this principal group here, what name should be used here? Secondary suffix must be used here. For principal group always, which name? Secondary suffix must be used here. What is that? oic acid. Oic acid should be used. Oic acid should be used. Next one, for the CHO, now for the CHO, now CHO acts as what? Second grade functional group. Substance simply. For this substance, what should be taken here? Formyl. At which position formyl is there? 5. So 5 formyl should be used here. 5 formyl should be used here. Is the concept clear? So whenever we take this type of structure, so what is the name here now? How many carbon atoms in the parent chain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons there. And at 5th position, what is the formyl is there? So what is the IUPAC name? Tell me. 5 formyl. How many carbons in the parent chain? 5. 5 indicates what? Bent. And between the carbon atoms, which bond is there? Single bond is there. So single bond indicates what? Pentan. And oic acid. In oic acid, first letter is what? Oval. O. When first letter is oval of secondary suffix, we should not write E here. We should not write E. We should write only A-N. Pentanoic acid. Pentanoic acid. So it is the name of this molecule. And the same structure we can draw like this here. Suppose. Here see. Here C double bond O H. Right? C double bond O H. And CH2, COOH. Is this same or not? Both are same. First one and this one. Both structures are same here. The same thing we have written in other formats. So the same thing they'll give sometimes bond line structure. Bond line structure, how they give you? So here like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. So here they give like this. This one of CO is what? COOH. And here in this case, CD CH2. After that, here again, C double bond O, single bond H. Okay, so this way also they will give sometimes. So here in this case, what we have to understand? Here in this case, here this should be carbon. This should be carbon with the C double bond O. C double bond O and CHO should be imagined. In this case, C double bond O. C double bond O, OH. It should be taken as COOH. So this should be imagined as COOH. This should be considered as what? CHO. The same thing. All are same here. Three are same. Okay. So now in this case, now number one is given to what? This carbon. And 2, 3, 4, 5. Position 5 is given to this carbon. That's a 5 formyl pentanoic acid. And one more thing what we have to understand is that, so here this side COOH is there. COOH is what now? Chain terminating carbon containing functional group containing oxygen. Chain terminating carbon containing functional group having oxygen. So when you start number one here, and there the fifth position C double bond O H means CHO actually. CHO means actually what? Aldehyde. Bond CHO it is. But CHO generally which name we have to use? Formyl we have to use. But upon modern concept, instead of formyl, we can also use here 5-oxo. 5-oxo also can be used here. Instead of formyl here, for the C double bond O, for a ketone, what we use generally? Oxo we use. For ketones, we use oxo. So 5-oxo also is correct here. So 5-formyl pentanoic acid we can take. Otherwise, 5-oxo pentanoic acid also correct. Is that concept clear? So tell me another way how to give the name to this here. This one we can write. Or tell me 5-oxo. 5-oxo pentanoic acid. Oic acid, 5-oxopentanoic acid. So 5-oxopentanoic acid is also correct here, according to modern concept. So what is the concept here? At one end, carbon containing functional group with CO should be there. Okay, oxygen should be there. And the other end also, the carbon containing group with oxygen should be there. In this condition, the C double bond OH, instead of formyl, we have to take what now? Oxo. 5-oxo or 5-formyl, both will be correct. Both can be taken as same. is a bunch of pair. Let's take the screenshot of this one. Now, next case. Now see, next example what I'm taking is here. C triple bond N is there, suppose. Cyanide bond CH2. Bond CH2. Bond CH2. Bond CHO is there. CHO means what? C double bond OH. Now tell me, which is principal group, which is second grade functional group here? Which is principal group, which is second grade functional group in this? Yes, cyanide is one group available here. Cyanide is one group is there. And CHO is one group. Which is principal group here? Which is senior? Cyanide is senior. It is what now here? Senior group. Senior functional group it is. Then what CHO? As it is senior functional group, number one should be allotted to this carbon. First carbon. Second carbon. Third carbon. Fourth carbon. Now five should be given or not to this CHO? Five should be given. Why? This is chain terminating carbon containing functional group having what oxygen here? Containing what oxygen here? The chain terminating, if the chain terminating group is having oxygen, it should be this carbon should be given position. That means this carbon should be given what? Fifth position. So like the carbon we got now here, first, second, third, fourth, fifth carbons, five carbons, three carbons. So five carbons indicates what now? Pet. And what name should be allotted for this CHO? Generally, formyl means. What we use here? Formyl. And here, cyanide. For this cyanide group, we should use cyano or nitrile. Which should be used here? Cyano or nitrile. It should be used what now here? Secondary prefix or secondary suffix for this? Secondary suffix we have to use. Secondary suffix is what for cyano group? It is nitrile. What is nitrile? So nitrile should be there here. And formyl is secondary prefix or secondary suffix? It is secondary prefix. Secondary prefix it is. Secondary prefix is formyl. Secondary suffix is what? Nitrile. Here why we should not take oxo here? C double bond O is there. Oxo we should not take here because this side CN is there. COOH is not there. This is not carbon containing with oxygen. This group is not carbon containing with oxygen. That's why here it should be given only formyl. Only formyl should be taken. Okay. So formyl is secondary prefix name of aldehyde group. And nitrile is secondary suffix of cyanide group. Now tell me name. What is the name for this? At which position formyl is there? Five. Formyl. Five formyl. After that, how many carbon atoms totally? Five carbons. So pent. Between the carbon atoms, which bonding is there? All single bonds there, na? So AN or ANEAN. In the secondary suffix, first letter is what? N. First letter is N indicating what? Consonant or vowel? It is consonant. If the secondary suffix starts from consonant, we should write ANE. E should be written here. ANE we have to write. Pentane. Then nitrile. Pentane. Nitrile. So it is what now? IUPAC name of this given structure. 5-formyl pentane nitrile. Pentane nitrile we have to take. Is the concept here? Take the screenshot of this one. Next. So now here, sometimes if COOH is repeated, if it is repeated more than two times the given structure, then which name we have to use for this COOH? The given structure, if COOH is repeated more than two times, which name we have to use here? Special secondary suffix must be used here. The secondary suffix is what now here? Carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. Okay, so we should not use here oic acid. We should not use here oic acid. And also we should not use here carboxy. Carboxy is what? Secondary prefix. It should not be used in oic acid. Oic acid should not be used here. We have used one only carboxylic acid. In which case, if same group is repeated more than two times, if carbon containing group is repeated more than two times, we have to take what now here special secondary suffix. That is what now carboxylic acid we have to use for COOH. Like this, different groups have different special secondary suffix names. That names we have to remember. Okay. Now we'll discuss about what now the secondary suffixes of some of the important carbon containing functional groups. Now check it. Suppose here, now I'm taking here functional group and special secondary suffix. Special secondary suffix and the functional group here. First, I'm taking here bond COOH. Bond COOH. For this, what is special suffix name here? For this carboxylic acid. If three times carboxylic acid is there, what we have to say? Tricarboxylic acid we have said. If four times there, tetracarboxylic acid we have said. But name what we have to use here? Carboxylic acid we have to use. We should neither use carboxy nor oic acid. We have to use carboxylic acid. Similarly, for bond CN, we use here carbonitrile. We should use what carbonitrile. We should neither use cyano nor nitrile. We must use what carbonitrile. In which case, if cyanide group is repeated more than two times. Okay, so like this here, carbonitrile should be used here. And for this CHO, bond CHO, for this we use here carbaldehyde. So carbaldehyde must be used here. So carbaldehyde is what now? Secondary suffix, special secondary suffix for CHO functional group. If CHO is repeated more than two times, that is three times or four times, we have to use what? Carbaldehyde. Okay. So next, bond COOR. What is bond COOR called? Ester. What is here? Ester. And what is this R called here? R is what? Alkyl. Alkyl. Okay. So here we use here alkyl. Whatever the alkyl group is present, that will be taken. If R is methyl, we say methyl. If it is R is ethyl, ethyl we say here. If any alkyl is there, we say alkyl carboxylate. Carboxylate. So alkyl carboxylate we must use here. So alkyl carboxylate is secondary suffix. That is special secondary suffix for ester. It is carbon containing functional group. Remember. And next one, bond CONH2. What is bond CONH2 called? Amide. Bond CONH2 group is called amide. Amide group it is. So for this we use here carboxamide. What we use? Carboxamide. So carboxamide is the special secondary suffix for CONH2. So what we take now here, carboxamide, alkyl carboxylate, carbaldehyde, carbonitrile, carboxylic acid as what now special secondary suffixes. Okay. So here we have taken functional group and special secondary suffix. Okay. So here for COOH, carboxylic acid. For CN, carbonitrile. For CHO, carbaldehyde. For ester, we use alkyl carboxylate. For amide, we use what? Carboxamide. Let's take the screenshot of this one. No. Some of the examples we'll discuss. Some of the examples. Suppose one example is like this. CH2 bond CN. Bond CH2 or CHCN. Bond CH2CN. Now, how many times cyanide is repeated? Three times. That means more than two times. Now we should not give numbering here. We should not take numbering 1, two, three, four, five carbons. You should not start number one here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons need not to take. Or we have to take longest chain only this one. It is what now here longest chain. So in this longest chain numbering what? First carbon, second carbon, third carbon. So three carbons are there. What is the name? Tell me here. Propane. Ane. Between carbon atoms in the parent chain, single bonds there. So propane. After that, at which position these carbonitrile groups are there? For this cyanide group, we have to use now carbonitrile because cyanide groups are repeated how many times? 3 times, more than 2 times. So we have to say now 1, 2, 3. Try 3 times repeated. Now try carbonitrile. Try carbonitrile is the IUPAC name of this molecule. Is that clear, ma? So it is what now here? Tricarbonitrile. Tricarbonitrile. Is the concept clear? See, next example, check it. Next example. Here. CH2 COOH. CH2 COOH bond. CH COOH bond. CH2 COOH. Now what is the name? Tell me. Here parent chain is what? How many carbon? Chain, three carbon chain should be taken. So here again what now? Propane. Propane. 1, 2, 3. Try carboxylic acid. Try carboxylic acid. Okay. So like this we have to say. Okay. Next. Now, in the previous example, we have got one question like this here. CH2 bond COOH. Okay, bond CH or C, COOH here and OH. Bond CH2 COOH. Okay, for this actual here, how many times COOH group repeated? 3 times. When 3 times COOH is repeated, what we can take now? We can take what? Parent chain as 3 carbons only. These 3 carbons only will be taken as parent. We should not give numbering to carboxylic acid groups. Numbering should be given only first position, it is. Second position, it is. Third position. 3 carbons should be taken. Now what should be named? Tell me. At second carbon, what is there here? At second carbon, what is there? Hydroxy group is there. 2-hydroxy. What is the name? 2-hydroxy. 2-hydroxy, propane, then 1, 2, 3, tricarboxylic acid, so tricarboxylic acid should be taken. It is actually, it is according to modern concepts.